Good afternoon. Myself, Dr. Mrs. Vaishali Patil, working as professor in the Department of Biochemistry, Dr. D. Y. Patil Medical College, Kolhapur. My topic is Learning Domains and Progression of Learning. Objectives are, at the end of the session, each participant should be able to enumerate the different educational domains, understand the different levels of each domain, and at the end of the session, each participant should be understand the applications of domain in the teaching and learning process. Suppose you are in the OPD and observing the patient of enteric fever. Can you enumerate various processes you are carrying in that patient? Means first you will take the history of the patient. Then depending upon the history, you will make the diagnosis and you will make the prescription. And at the end, you will explain the treatment and the diet plan for that specific disease. Okay? Means what you will do means these are categorized into various levels. Means you did the related to knowledge, related to performance, or related to communication. Then let us try to understand these in more useful terms or technical terms. So our medical education is divided into three domains. It is called as the taxonomy of domains, and which is discovered by the scientist Bloom. It is called as Bloom's taxonomy. And according to Bloom's, there are three main categories or three classification of domains. These are, first is the cognitive domain, or it is also called as the domain of knowledge, or it is the domain of mind. This is the very famous example. So it is deals with only knowledge. Then this cognitive domain, it is further divided into various levels. As the course advances, the students are assessed to the higher level of domain. So there are various types or higher levels of cognitive domains, such as knowledge, it is the basic level, comprehension, application, analysis, synthesis, evaluation. So this domain deals with knows and knows how. So the main categories or main levels of this cognitive domain is, level 1 deals with knowledge, then level 2, slightly higher level than knowledge, that is comprehension, and level 3, higher level of comprehension, that is problem solving. So we'll see the examples of these three levels of cognitive domain. This is the level 1, cognitive level 1, and this level deals with only knowledge or recall or remembering. So this is the example of Gita Patan competition. Okay. So here in this level, knowledge is assessed or recall capacity of the student is assessed. This is the basic or the first domain of cognitive. Then the skill demonstrated in this domain is observation and recall of information, knowledge of dates and events and places, knowledge of major ideas, mastery of subject matters, and to frame the question for assessment of this knowledge or the first cognitive domain is, certain action verbs are used. These are list, define, tell, describe, identify, show, label, collect, etc. Then next is the level 2. This is related to comprehension, slightly higher than that of the knowledge, that is understanding. So this is the example of cognitive level 2. So this person, he is depending upon his knowledge of honey, so he is applying that knowledge for comprehension. This is slightly higher than the knowledge, that is cognitive level 2. Then how to assess this domain? So skill assessed in this domain is understanding information, grasp meaning, translate knowledge into new context, and the action verbs to frame this question is summarize, describe, interpret, contrast, predict, associate, etc. Next is the cognitive level 3, that is application. So this is the example of cognitive level 3. In this domain, this person, depending upon his knowledge and comprehension, he is apply his knowledge and he analyze and synthesize the new method. So in this method is the protected method or safe method to remove the honey. So this is the higher level of cognitive domain. It is the third level. And this level deals with application, analysis and synthesis. Then the skill demonstrated in this level, that is application, is use information, use methods, concepts, theories in new situations, solve problems using required skill and or knowledge. Action verbs to assess this level is apply, demonstrate, calculate, complete, illustrate and show. These are the various action verbs which is used to assess the specific level of the cognitive domain. Then the more higher level of cognitive domain, it is the judgment or ultimate level. So this level deals with the independent judgment or evaluation. So this is the example of cognitive level 4. Then the demonstration of skill is carried out by compare and discriminate between ideas, assess values of theories, presentations, make choices based on reason, argument, and action verbs used is assess, decide, rank, grade, test, measure, etc. So these action verbs assess the evaluation domain, that is the higher level of cognitive domain. Then how to frame the question? These are the various levels of cognitive domain and how the framing of questions are carried out using that various action verbs. So first is the knowledge, that is the cognitive level 1 domain. So it deals with recall of data or information. Then how to frame the question for assessment of knowledge. So for example, enumerate 5 side effects of rifampicin. So this question assesses the first level of cognitive domain. Then next is the second level of cognitive domain is comprehension. So comprehension means understand, explain in own words. So example, explain the mechanism of hepatotoxicity by rifampicin. Then the next level is application. So use of concept in new situations. How to frame the question? Calculate the dose of rifampicin for a 20 kg patient. Then next level is the analysis. So it is a distinguish between facts and inferences. So how to frame the question? Discuss the advantages of using rifampicin in the initial treatment. Then the synthesis, that is a higher level of cognitive domain. So it is builds whole from the parts and derived meaning from a new whole. How to frame the question to assess the synthesis domain or the higher level of cognitive domain? Discuss characteristic of drug which prevent development of drug resistance. And how to evaluate this type of domain, that is evaluation domain. So select the most appropriate drug for drug resistance tuberculosis. So these are the various examples to assess various levels of cognitive domain. Then second domain is the psychomotor domain. It is also called as the domain of hand. It is deals with, or this domain deals with the skill. And the popular example is this one. It is related to only skill. Then the various levels of psychomotor domain is level 1 imitation, level 2 practice, and level 3 automatism. So this domain deals with knows, knows how, shows and does. So what is imitation? So here imitation is the observation of skill, is the first level of psychomotor domain. Then practice is the second level of psychomotor domain. Here in the presence of expert you have to perform the skill, is the second level of psychomotor domain. Then the automatism, so here because of the more practice, or it is the exactness because of repeated practice, and it reached the level of independent, that is the automatism. So these are the various levels of psychomotor domain. Level 1 is imitation, level 2 is practice, and level 3 is the automatism. Then the routine examples are, so psychomotor domain level 1 is imitation. So here this boy is observing how the newspaper man throwing the newspaper along with balancing the bicycle. He is observing, that is he is imitating. This is the first level of psychomotor domain. Here he is not doing anything, but he is observing. So this is the imitation, only observation. Then second level is the practicing, means in presence of expert he is practicing. This is the second level of psychomotor domain. And this is the third level, that is automatism or automation. So because of this practice he got the control, or he can do the all the things or skills independently. That is a higher level of psychomotor domain. Then third level or third domain is the affective domain. It is very important domain, and nowadays this domain is lagging. So to maintain the doctor-patient relationship, so this domain deals with the attitude and communication. It is also called as the domain of heart. Example is, this is the affective domain. So this domain deals with various valuing, means sympathy, empathy. So this deals with the communication and various valuing. Then levels of this affective domain. Level 1 is receiving, level 2 is responding, and level 3 is internalization. This affective domain deals with knows, knows how, shows and does. What is receiving? So receiving means paying attention is the receiving, is the first level of affective domain. Level 2 is responding, means participation. And the third level is internalization, means showing various values, sympathy, like that. Means it deals with emotions. So the affective domain is again having the three levels. First is the receiving, second level is the responding, and third is the internalization. So a routine example is, suppose in a ward mother is crying, and first the doctor is hearing that crying voice, means he is attending that voice. So this is the first level of affective domain. Then he is asking the reason of crying, means he is participating in that situation, means this is the second level, that is the responding. And internalization, he is showing sympathy towards that patient, is the third level of the affective domain. Okay. So the examples of affective domain, so this is the combination of level 1 and level 2. So in this example, the lady heard the voice of beggar, means she is attending and she is giving food, means she is participating or responding. And so this is the combination of level 1 and 2. And this is the affective domain level 3. It is showing sympathy. So this is the our mythological example. This is Lord Yudhishthir and his readiness to sacrifice everything for a cherished family. This is the higher level of affective domain. So this is about the various levels of domain or taxonomy of domain. It deals with the various skills, deals with the mind, and it deals with the communication scheme. Then conclusion, rigid classification of professional activities may not be possible. Still, domains of learning guides teachers to emphasize different level from different domains in their teaching. We should not ignore affective domain because it teaches good communication skill for students, and the affective domain, it is useful for longer duration of time because it is used for maintaining the doctor-patient relationship. Okay, thank you very much. These are various references.